folks, and welcome to Gourmet's Shed. This week we're looking at making some stone walls out of polished styrene, and it's like these little things over here. I made these stone walls the other day out of polished styrene, and cut them out and coloured them up with acrylic paints, etc. This one, and also the one at the back over there. And today I'm going to show you the process I followed to get to that stage. I'm quite pleased with the result, and especially the one at the back there. I think it's got the look of a stone wall. Anyway, it's good enough for me, so we'll go on out into the workshop now and I'll show you how it's done. Okay, this is what we're using. It's just a piece of everyday polystyrene. It's packaging out of some appliance or whatever that we've bought. Can't remember now exactly where it came from. It's fairly rigid. It's, you know, it's got a bit of width to it, but it doesn't really matter what you use. You can achieve some good results. And this is my weapon of choice. This is what is called a rasp. It's a very coarse file for anyone who's not familiar with what a rasp is. And this one's been around for a while. It's lost its handle and everything, but it has teeth that are angled one way, a bit like rearranging the teeth on a saw blade, but these are in rows. I'll just bring it closer. These are in rows down the rasp, and when you push backwards that way, upwards, you can feel that they're sharp. And they're spaced a few millimeters apart, and the rasp is meant to be used in that direction across a piece of wood or whatever to roughly shape it. And then you can do some fine work later on with a proper file. You can also use the back edge. That's set up the same way. And that, I actually use the back edge, but not in the way that it's intended. I'll show you how I do that on the polystyrene in a while. If you don't have a rasp, you can get a similar result with a handsaw. And it's just an ordinary, everyday, knocked-about old handsaw. And you can use that pretty much in the same way that I'm going to use the rasp on the polystyrene. So we'll have a look at that now. Now, a word of warning, this process makes a lot of mess. You're going to get all these little polystyrene beads all over the place. So I'm doing it obviously in my workshop. I would recommend that you do it in a shed or outdoors or whatever. If you're going to attempt this inside, fellas, you better make sure that you send your missus out with plenty of money to go shopping, because if she comes home and finds you making a mess in the kitchen, you're going to be in more trouble than a one-legged bloke in an ass-kicking contest, I can tell you. So just think about it before you do it. Right, I've locked my polystyrene down in a vise, but you could also use a clamp and clamp it down on the side of a table. You could fit it into one of the Black & Decker Workmates and lock it up that way. It's good if you can hold it or have something hold it steady for you so you can apply some pressure with the rasp or the saw, whatever you use. Now, the method is as simple as this. Because of the teeth being spaced in rows, those rows are going to become my courses of stones, if you like. This process will leave lines in the polystyrene, a bit like courses in a stone wall or a brick wall. And all I do is, I've got the rasp on the curved side. It just seems to work better for me that way. And I hold it on the polystyrene quite firm, and I just drag it along like that a couple of times. And you can see it's starting to make a mess. Now we'll just get rid of some of that. And you can see that it's left these lines in there like courses. Now, it's a little bit rough, but that's what we want. It's supposed to be a stone wall, so it's not perfect like a brick wall. So that's pretty good. So that's one side. Now, while I've got it there in the vise, I might as well cut off the slice of brick wall I want. And I'm not taking any sort of careful measurements. I'm just sort of doing it by eye for this demonstration. But obviously you can do it more carefully if you want to. I'm using that handsaw I just showed you a minute ago. I'll slice that off. Like a knife through butter. There we go. It's making quite a mess in here.
blooming. Now, I'll just rub some of the excess off there. Now, this is the side we've already done, so we've got to do this side. Now, that's what it looks like after it's just been cut, which is pretty rough. I guess that's a bit like a stone wall as well. But I'd like to run the rasp over that as well to sort of get those courses showing up in it. So all I'm going to do is hold it down against the block that's already still sitting there in the vise, and I'll run the rasp over this as well. Now, I'm just going to hold it down on the block there, and I'm going to use the other hand to hold the rasp and just drag it along away from me, along the piece of polystyrene. And that's made some courses, and then I'll just turn it around and I'll work back the other way. Like that. Give it one more go, that'll do. And that's done. So there's the second bit. So that's the other side. So that's easy. And now all I've got to do is cut it to, say, the height I want. That's a bit too high. So it's just a matter of using the saw on it, which is pretty easy. I'll just lay it on something flat and then cut it. Okay, I cut it down its length. Didn't measure it, just took a punt at it. And you can see there's actually two bits there. So I've just done two walls and quite a good length. And all we need to do now is, you know when you look at some of these walls and you see like stones are laid in, not vertically, but a bit of an angle, but it looks sort of vertical. Well, the way I achieve that is just get a, I've got an old hacksaw blade here somewhere, and I'll show you that in a second. I'll get it out and I'll show you what I mean. Right, I've got my hacksaw blade. It's just one that snapped off. Now, after I've cut this bit of stuff in half, basically what I've done is I've selected the smoothest edges. They will be my the faces that are glued to a board or your scenery or whatever you're doing. And I'll use the rougher edges, the top, as the ones that I'll cut with the hacksaw blade. And all I do is make a series of cuts. How can I show you? Right. I just run across the top edge and make a light cut with a hacksaw blade, random, but spaced fairly close together. And that's to simulate, you know, stones stacked vertically or at an angle on top of the wall. Now, it's going to be difficult to sort of appreciate it here. I'll rub some of that off. You won't be able to see exactly what I mean. And actually, I probably could have gone a bit deeper there. But I'll show you on the ready-made model. But what happens with these now is you colour them up, use your base colour, like a grey or a dark grey or whatever, and then you can put washes of browns and darker browns and whatever over the base colour to simulate a stone wall. And it's as simple as that. And the thing about them is that they can bend. I mean, you can only go so far before it breaks, but if it does break, it's pretty easy to glue it again. I mean, that's bending around a corner, and this is the wall which would bend a bit, you know, say over scenery, or you could even put a break in it and then do a join so that it works okay. So yeah, we'll just have a closer look now at the ones I've already made. Right, you can see here how the cuts have been done in the top of the wall. I think it just improves the look of it, and it looks as though stones have been stacked in there. But I think what really makes the difference is the colouring. And, you know, it requires a bit of time to add different bits of shading and so on to the wall. And then, obviously, you can grow some stuff on it as well. You can glue some foliage on there. And you know, I don't think it needs distressing anymore. I mean, if you look at this one at the back, that looks fairly distressed already, like a wall that's had a bit of a hard life. But all that is polystyrene, same process as I've just showed you, and acrylic paint. It's as simple as that.
And it's so easy. If you stuff it up, just chuck the piece away and start again. Or the piece that you've mucked up, you can bury it under a hill in some of your scenery. So there you are, folks.
Right. Now I've got to get the vacuum cleaner out and vacuum up all this polystyrene that's around here. Okay. See you, folks. Cheers. Gourmet.